الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ثم أما بعد أيها الأحبة في الله أفضل الدعاء الحمد لله وأفضل العمل اتباع السنة وأفضل الذكر لا إله إلا الله. يقول الإمام الشاطبي رحمه الله روى القلب في ذكر الله. Brothers and sisters, the best of dua is to say Alhamdulillah. وإذ تأذن ربكم لئن شكرتم لأزيدنكم. When you say Alhamdulillah, automatically you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the same time, you're asking Him for more. And guaranteed you will get it. The best of actions following the sunnah. Doesn't matter what you do, how beautiful it looks. It's not good unless it is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The best of dhikr, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to say la ilaha illallah. This is the word that you created for, and you want to live on, and you want to be dying on it and resurrected on it, and there is nothing equivalent to it. Imam al-Shatibi rahimahullah said, "Riwa al-qalb fi dhikrillah." When you get thirsty, you drink. When your heart gets thirsty, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quenches the thirst. Akthir min qawl la ilaha illallah. وأكثر من ذكر الله بتلاوة كلام الله سبحانه وتعالى. Always say لا إله إلا الله. It renews your faith. And always recite the book of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. That is the best of the remembrance and the best of ذكر you can have. Simple equation. أذكروني أذكركم. معادلة بسيطة. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول عندما تذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى يذكرك يذكرك بالخير ينعم عليك ييسر أمورك يفتح عليك يبارك لك يشفيك يحميك يهديك كل هذا. When you remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He remembers you. He never forgets you, but He remembers you in the sense that now you're becoming a point of blessing. He will give you, He will save you, He will protect you, He will heal you, He will bless you, simply. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to remember Him. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اُذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. O you who believe, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala plenty, a lot. And glorify Him morning and evening, basically all day. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you to do that, what is the understanding of dhikr? If we look at our life, مفهوم الحياة جميعا, الدنيا هي قرآن صامت والقرآن قرآن ناطق. When you look at this universe, the universe is a silent Quran. So what is the dhikr in it? To reflect and think. رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ. Wallah, you did not create this in vain. You see the beauty in this life, in the nature, in the skies, in the rain. You see all of that. It's something for you to reflect on the Creator who created it. So this is the dhikr of it. When you look at the Quran, it is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So actually, it's an action, it's a word. So the reflection on it, to think about it, is to recite the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Quran yamshi ala al-ard. والذكر في هذا المجال هو اتباع السنة. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a Quran walking on earth. What does that mean? He fulfills the commands of the Quran. Whatever the Quran says, he puts it in practice. So Quran is not revealed for you and me to just recite it and not understand it, or just recite it and understand it and not practice it. So remembering the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to have dhikr is to follow his sunnah in real life. How was he dealing with him, with himself? How is he carrying himself? How does he deal with the people when he is happy, when he is mad, with the family, with the newcomers, with the knowledge, with all of that? How does he do? You do the same thing. اعلم أنه ما صعد شيء إلى السماء أعظم من الإخلاص. Pay attention to this. This is the focal point of our whole worship. Ikhlas, sincerity. There is nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِلَيْهِ يَصْعَدْ الْكَلِمُ الطَّيِّبِ. The good word ascends to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our actions ascend to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, they're presented to Him twice. Well, let me say three times, since we are not going by week. Mondays, Thursdays of every week, and in the month Sha'ban, our actions presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the most important of those acts is sincerity. So anything that ascends to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing bigger and more rewarding than being sincere. And what does being sincere mean? It means that when you do something, you don't expect someone to say thank you. Yes, as simple as thank you. You don't expect it. Much less to say you're expecting him to do the same to you or reward you or carry you when you fall. Or, no. إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. We only do this to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised you He will take care of you. People can never take care of you. And if they do, they will never do it like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never let you down. People let you down. So if you want to live a happy life, you need to make sure that you are sincere and in dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rather than dealing with people. So when you do, don't look at the people, don't look at the administration, don't look at who is there and who is not. Look at why you're doing it. I'm doing it to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is the way to do it. There is nothing more clear than the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is the robe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you want to be holding fast to it. Quran is the robe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حَبْلُ الْمَتِينَ طَرَفُهُ بِيَدِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَالطَّرَفُ الْآخَرُ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ فَتَمَسَّكْ بِهِ. Hold fast to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you can never do that unless you follow the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he is the one who told you how to hold fast to it. He is the one who told you how to understand it and how to apply it and what it means, and it was revealed with him so he can convey it to him. Without him, the Quran is not here. So pay attention to the understanding of holding fast to the Quran. It is holding fast to the Quran and the Sunnah. They go hand in hand. They never separate. You separate them, you're misguided. So just a small story that I want to relate to you. Because most of us, if I ask, brother, do you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who's going to say no? Everybody's going to say yes. We love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed. But what's the proof? Well, there's a story. A servant woman, one of the judges of Al-Basra in Iraq, he had a servant, a new servant that he purchased, or slave. And he doesn't know her manners. So late at night, he woke up checking on her. He went to her room, couldn't find her. So he thought evil of her. Kept looking around the house. He found her prostrating in a corner, praying, PM. That's what you're doing and I'm doing. That's what we're enjoying in this last month of Ramadan, the last 10 days. And she was making a dua. And he can hear the dua. And her dua was, Allahumma inni as'aluka bihubbika li an taghfira li. O Allah, I ask you, by the virtue of you loving me, to forgive me. Well, the judge did not like it much, because he said, بِحُبِّكَ لِي أَنْ تَغْفِرْ لِي الْمَفْرُودِ تكون بِحُبِّي لَكَ أَنْ تَغْفِرْ لِي. He said, it should have been that, will my love to you forgive me, not your love to me forgive me. So he kept it until she finished. Then when she finished, he told her, you're supposed to make the dua differently. You're supposed to say, oh Allah, because I love you, forgive me. Or through the virtue of me loving you, forgive me, not you loving me. How do you know he loves you? Good question. Look at her answer. قالت ليس المهم أن تحب لكن المهم أن تحب ولولا حبه لي ما أيقظني وأغفلك. Subhanallah. She told him, it's not important that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because everybody claims it. What's important, him loving you. And because he loves me, and the proof that he loves me, he woke me up to do tahajjud, and he did it. Wake you up. Rather, he woke you up to check on me. Subhanallah. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make a dua, Allahumma inni as'aluka hubbak. Oh Allah, I ask you to love me. Which is really, if you think about it, you're basically asking him hidayah, tawfiq. Therefore, anything that ascends to the sky, nothing more rewarding than ikhlas. And once you do that, nothing more valuable that descends from the sky to us, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more valuable than tawfiq. Guiding you while you're here. How come some people are not here? Why you came early and some people came late? Well, some people still did not come yet. Why? You think it just happened random? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saw goodness in you. He brought you here. He helped you come here. He helped you close the shop. He helped you leave work. He helped you not fall in traffic, not break your car, not making you sick, no emergency situations. He helped you subhanahu wa ta'ala because he gave you tawfiq. He saw the goodness in you. And that is the most important thing that you get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The prophets, they said, وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَإِلَيْهِ أُنِيبُ. There is nothing, no tawfiq I can get from anyone except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Upon him, I rely. يَوْمُكْ يَقُلْ عُلَمَا يَوْمُكْ كَجَمَلِكُ إِنْ أَمْسَكْتَ أَوَّلَهُ تَبِعُكَ آخِرُ. Your day is like your camel. If you hold him from the front with the rein, what happens? The rest of the camel follow. And your day is like that. If you will start good with Fajr prayer, guess what? The rest of the day will be good. How about Ramadan? If you start Ramadan good, the rest of it will be good. If you start the khutbah attentive, you will be attentive. You will not fall asleep. If you fall asleep, what do? What's the sunnah? Move. Get up from your spot and move to another spot. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that some people might be tired and fall asleep. So if you start something good from the beginning,
The end of it usually ends up good. Many of us work so hard in Ramadan, in the beginning. And the most important is intention. It's not like because, oh, everybody's preparing, I gotta go prepare. The whole shops are busy, I gotta buy my box of dates or get the cookies and all of those things, the carrot. And no, that's not how you prepare. You prepare with the intention. جاءكم الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he mentioned Ramadan, he said, a blessed month. Shayateen chain, Jannah open, hellfire closed, wonderful things. You need to prepare for it with ikhlas. You do that, you will do good. What if you did it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. Some people may not. Some people may start and slack. He gave you a night in the last 10 days to cheer you up again. Laylatul Qadr. Khayrun min alf shahr. Better than 1,000 months of worship. Basically, if you give $10, it's like you gave $10 for 1,000 months. If you pray to rak'ah, same thing. Anything you do is multiplied so much. He gave it to you so he cheers you up again. He knows how we are. We get so excited and then we calm down. And ourselves is weak. And that's why we always need the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. Brothers and sisters, when we think about our life, you should think of three things. Three questions. Who is your Lord? Man Rabbu? Madin, what's your religion? So when you say I'm a Muslim, don't cover yourself. Don't hide yourself. Don't change your name. Don't fake your identity and tell me you're a proud Muslim. You're not. So the answer for I'm a Muslim, the day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you in the grave, you're not going to speak fluently and it comes out of your heart, because it's not. When you are ashamed of your name, and it could be a wonderful name, Muhammad, Abdullah, Abdurrahman, you change it to Mo. Oh, mashallah, you're really proud. I'm serious. Well, you know, I like to say it as is. Because when we ask, again, the same thing, when we ask, do you love this? Are you proud of Islam? Yes. Are you happy? Yes. Then what? Show us. You're changing your name. You don't look like a Muslim. Your behavior is not like a Muslim. And you're calling yourself a Muslim. So this is not the point. Man Rabbuk, who's your Lord? It's not just Allah. Make sure you serve Him. Madinuk, Islam. It's not just Islam. Make sure you look like one and you act like one. Waman Nabiyuk, who's your prophet? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's not just like, oh, I love Muhammad, oh, Muhammad is my Lord. No. Do you look like him? Do you try to look like him? Why we copy everything else, but we don't copy the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Because we love that and we don't love this. We just fake. So, prepare yourself for answers. And the answer comes automatic. يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will affirm your heart automatically if you live this way. So we got that. Three questions. Who's your Lord? What's your religion? And who is your prophet? Jibreel alayhi salam came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked him three questions. Or he told him, gave him three advices. Ya Muhammad, عِشْ مَا شِئْ فَإِنَّكَ مَيِّتْ. Oh Muhammad, let me give you the good news. Live as long as you want to live. 100 years, 200, 3,000, 10,000, million, you're gonna die. أُقْسِمْ بِاللَّهِ لَوْ نِتْفَكَّرْ فِي الْمُوتِ لَنْكُونْ أَسْعَدِ الْخَلْقِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرِ. ووالله لولا ذلك لما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أكثروا من ذكر هذه اللذة. I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that if you think about death always, you will be the happiest person on earth and in the hereafter. The complete opposite of what people think. Oh, you always talk about death. Talk about something good. This is good. You think Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells you to remember death all the time because it's bad? That's the fake understanding. Everyone memorizes the hadith or the ayah, but
in reality, they don't know what it means or how to put it in practice.
Ya Muhammad, عش ما شئت فإنك ميت. Live as long as you want to live. So yes, go ahead, collect, build, do, act, grow your muscles. Spend your time, 12 hours in the gym, and mashallah, perfect. But Isha prayer, you cannot stand for 2 minutes of recitation Quran. You're so tired, you start wobbling like a yo-yo. But over there, you're pumping 300, 400, 500, mashallah, you can barely walk. Okay, you're gonna die. You're gonna deflate all that good stuff that you think you have. What's next? Wallahi, in Surah الشعراء الله سبحانه وتعالى قال أفرأيتم إن متعناهم أفرأيت إن متعناهم سنين. Oh Muhammad, do you see if we really let them enjoy themselves for years? ثم جاءهم ما كانوا يوعدون. Then the promise that I promised them, what's the promise? كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul shall taste death. So this promise comes to them, meaning they die. What's the result? مَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يُمَتَّعُونَ.
What good what they were enjoying did for them. What good your muscles did, what good your houses did, your car, your business, your money, your family, your nothing. Why? Because you died. You left everything. You came empty-handed and you're gonna go empty-handed. So what do you focus on? Actions. Actions with sincerity, according to the sunnah, you will live good and you will be happy. نَحْنُ أُمَّةِ عِلْمٍ وَعَمَلٍ وَإِجَابِيَّةٍ. Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ummah of knowledge, action, and positivity. That means it's not like I learned and I don't do anything about it. No, I do anything, something about it. It's not like I do based on no knowledge. No, I have knowledge and I do it too. And it's not like I do everything and whenever something happens, I collapse. No, I'm positive. I'm always optimistic. I always look forward. I always know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with me and He will support me and He will take care of me. This is Islam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمدا يوافي نعمه يدفع نقمه واشهد ان لا اله الا الله واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله ثم اما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, the last minutes of Ramadan. احمل هما واحدا كيف ترضي الله سبحانه وتعالى. Just make your worry one worry. How to please Allah سبحانه وتعالى. I know that this life is a journey. Given to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you're going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so make sure you do it for His sake, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was asked by a companion, what is the best thing that you can tell me that I can learn from you and act upon? He said, عليك بالصيام فإنه لا مثل له. He told him, I enjoin upon you fasting. This is extra fasting. There's nothing like it. There's nothing like it in rewards. Why? Because it purifies you. Because it makes you a human being. Because it makes you understand how weak you are and how much you are in need for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It makes you feel with other people. It makes you powerful. If you can win against your desire, you are the strongest man on earth. Because who falls for the desires? Animals. Anytime they feel hungry, they want to eat, and they go for it, and they kill for it. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you not, you're tough. You see the food, and you see the temptation, but you are a man. You can control yourself. So Ramadan
supposed to build all of those things in you. That's why it's for the purpose of taqwa, and that's what real taqwa is. We're about to graduate. Guess what? This is the end of Ramadan. You started with the certificate in the beginning. You're working for it. A few days and you graduate. Well, you better graduate. Some will graduate. I know if you worked hard, you would graduate. And I know if you were sincere, you would graduate. Because that's the whole goal and that's the whole purpose of the whole thing. Brothers and sisters, the best thing that you can do is to hold fast to the command and attach your heart to the hereafter. And the best thing you can do when you do that is to give. Because when you give, this is the true love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the Prophet said, وَصَدَقَ بُرْهَانٌ. Sadaqa is a proof that you truly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. IQA, who doesn't know IQA? Wonderful school. All the way from KG to 12. MashaAllah, integrating Texas curriculum and Islamic studies and tahfidh, all in one. Graduated in Hifl, 126 hafiz, mashallah. Graduated this year from high school, 13, five of them huffaz, mashallah. And you know I work with Islamic School of Irving, and one of the graduates was Hafiz. She was commended by the school, the university, the grade. She has a full scholarship. She was commended by it because she's Hafiz of the Quran. Non-believers commending Muslim on Hafiz of the Quran. This wonderful school, IQA, have that many. All universities around here are taking their students. Imagine over 200,000, over 250,000, or about 250,000 in total credits for scholarships for the students. And I believe seven of them, free ride, all of it, living and food and all costs. A school like that, brothers, for our youth, if you don't support, if you don't love, you have defect in loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because what they're doing is memorizing the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What they're doing is learning how to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are the only hope after the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you don't raise children from little age, I don't know what to expect. So brothers, in these wonderful days, today is what? In Ramadan, 27, right? Laylatul Qadr, inshallah. So you plan for giving, support IQA, and give. And leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take care of you. Leave the tawfiq to come down on you, and at the same time, brothers, give it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And many of us want to give zakah. Good having you for zakah, I don't know what else. Where do we get the money for masajid or for school? Nobody supports us except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the support of the people. So zakah is there. Plan to give, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the health and the wealth and take care of you. And inshallah, your children will be good and righteous, yourself good and righteous, healthy and well. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for your time and reward you for your money. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you live on Islam and die on Islam. وَلَا تُمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يبارك لنا في يومنا, وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه, أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها, أنت وليها مولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Inshallah, brothers, after we'll have 5 minutes, inshallah, fundraising to support IQA. Please stay behind. Just may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give reward for just staying, inshallah. And there will be an announcement, inshallah, for this wonderful message. Jazakumullah khairan. Akhir salam.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
Allahu Ekber. Elhamdülillahi Rabbil Alemin. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Maliki Yevmiddin. İyyâke na'budu ve iyyâke nesta'in. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
واذكر عبادنا إسحاق ويعقوب أولي الأيدي والأبصار إنا أخلصناهم بخالصة ذكر الدار وإنهم عندنا لمن المصطفين الأخيار واذكر إسماعيل واليسع وذا الكفل وكل من الأخيار هذا ذكر وإن للمتقين لحسن مآب جنات عدن مفتحة لهم الأبواب الله سميع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
هذا ذكر وإن للمتقين لحسن مآب جنات عدن مفتحة لهم الأبواب متكئين فيها يدعون فيها بفاكهة كثيرة وشراب وعندهم قاصرات الطرف أتراب هذا ما توعدون هذا ما توعدون ليوم الحساب إِنَّ هَذَا لَرِزْقُنَا مَا لَهُ مِنْ نَفَادٍ. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله.